Speech is one of the most important aspects of many animations. Due to the complexity of the human face, it is also one of the most challenging things to animate realistically. I am aware of two techniques of accomplishing this in Poser: Mimic, a product from DAZ3D, and Talk Designer, which is a native tool within Poser since version 7. Both tools work fairly well if your character is already rigged for phonemes and configuration files already exist for the character you want to animate. Normally, you will find the characters you want to use are already pre-rigged and configured. Most of DAZ3D products have been professionally designed. They include Phoneme Morphs and the associated DAZ Mimic configuration file. Likewise, most of Poser's out-of-box content is similarly designed, with phonemes and XML configuration files for Talk Designer. I picked up a figure from Vanishing Point which I wanted to use in some animations. Then the problem. It was not rigged for Mimic or Poser. After some amount of research, I decided the easiest way to get the character to talk was to use Poser's Talk Designer. And then the next problem hit me. I could not locate any documentation or videos on how to accomplish the goal. A phoneme is a linguistic term for the positions of the tongue, lips, and teeth as they make sounds. Poser allows you to create the appearance of phonemes to accurately simulate speech. A VisemeMap file provides information about which phonemes are matched to which specific facial expressions. We are going to create a set of phoneme morphs for the religion or figure, then take an existing VisemeMap file and customize it for the religion or product, or monk as the figure is named within Poser. We are going to locate a similar character to model their phonemes for our target figure who is already on stage. The model character has a full set of morphs for us. Once the example character is on stage, we are going to zoom in to see both faces clearly. Prior to configuring the target figure, we need to create a group structure where the phoneme morphs we are about to create will live. In the model figure, there is a morphs directory with a phoneme subdirectory. So on the target figure, we will just click Create a New Group, label it Morphs, click Create a New Group again, and label it Phonemes. In our model figure, we are going to enable the first phoneme. In this example, it will be the mouth A. On our target figure, we will attempt to match the mouth visually as close to the model figure as we can using whatever mouth morphs currently exist. Once it is where we need it to be, we will click Object on the menu bar, spawn Morph Target, and name the morph for the appropriate phoneme. In this case, mouth A. Repeat these steps until you have created all of the phoneme morphs. Once complete, you will save your new figure to your library. Name it something meaningful, like the original figure name, and add with phonemes. Now we are going to take an existing VisemeMap configuration file and modify it so the Talk Designer knows how to keyframe for audio. Use some type of XML editor so you can see the XML hierarchy properly. First step, open an existing VisemeMap file and rename it immediately. I used monk visemeMap.xml. On the first tag, edit the internal figure name that is listed in the library, the one you just created with all the phoneme morphs. Next, go through the entire phoneme list and match it to the morph names you just meticulously created. After you have modified the phoneme definitions, match up the blink morph. On this particular figure, the morph is eye close. Verify that the head, bend, and side-to-side parameter names match to how the figure has it named. In this case, they do. In future animations, I will explore creating the emotion configurations. First, you load up the sound file. Then load up your VisemeMap file. And click Apply. In future animations, I will explore creating the emotion configurations. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on rigging characters for Talk Designer. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will be creating more tutorials on topics which don't have any coverage up to this point.